Everybody, it's Invicta. It's time for another Eden Run here, the Binding of Isaac Victa Repentance series. Welcome to the newly updated Isaac. This is the first episode I'm going to be recording on the new patch. So for those of you who missed all the changes or any of the changes, check out the patch notes video that I did over the weekend with the surprise update that Tyrone dropped for Isaac 1.7.9. And I'm looking forward to hopefully maybe seeing some of the new items, or not, I say new items, but newly updated items. I'm looking forward to it, especially looking out for Athame, because I'm hearing good things about Athame, as I predicted that it was going to be pretty broken. So here's your meme of the day, brought to you here by Just Civil, or Sylvie? I think it's Sylvie. Athame was Giga Chads of the week so far. Yes, indeed. Of course, this was last week, but with Sharpstraw and Succubus taking over, man, those alternate ways of dealing damage are a doozy, and let's see what we have going on today. Okay. Today's going to be 6-7 Zulu Tango, X-Ray 8-8 Lima. Well, if we wanted to see the new Athame, now is the perfect time to, I suppose, but it feels a little bit iffy coming away from using Death Certificate on it. Do we use Athame? Do we get Athame for Death Certificate? Surely not, right? I'm going to wait and hold. I'm going to hold off on the on the Satanic Bible for now. Oh my goodness, what is going on with this run? Well, we started with horrible damage, but not anymore in the span of two rooms, not even including the fact that we're starting with Death Certificate. We get double our damage and the Bookworm transformation. Oh my god, and Keeper Sack is in here. What on earth is the seed? This might be one of the greatest seeds to ever start in Isaac. Holy smokes, man. And we got a library, and we're going to be able to get the Satanic Bible or the Book of Shadows after this. Honestly, I'm almost thinking that we go Satanic Bible for the first time in a long time, just because I want to get a Athame. I know that people, man, I don't know. It feels wrong for me to go after, to take a Athame with Death Certificate here. I definitely could do it, but there's a chance that we could also see it if we take the Satanic Bible and use it. Man, that to use a Death Certificate just for the pure. Man, are we really going to do that? I obviously we want to try to get Keeper Sack here as well. That would be a huge bonus for us. Don't mind going into the item here. We get Shade. Now, Shade actually has been changed from the patch notes. I believe that it, and look at that. There we go. We get the nickel. So we get basically everything that we want. Wow. I have never seen an Isaac start like this. This is absolutely unheard of. We're going to end up getting Keeper's Sack here, along with basically everything else that we ever wanted. Almost literally, because we're about to use Death Certificate. Now, we have two options here. We can look for a Athame, or we could actually take C-section as well, which did get nerfed. Lil Dumpy, of course, also got changed. If we take a Athame, I'm actually really curious to see what the interaction between a Athame and C-section is going to be. I know that we've been taking C-section quite a while, but that is something that I am curious about. And again, if we take the Satanic Bible, there's a very good chance that we're going to see a Athame. Like, very good chances. Hey! Obviously, one of the other big changes that that they did here for the Death Certificate room on the newest patch is that if you do happen to get an item from one of the chests in the Death Certificate room, you will no longer that will no longer screw you and take your item away. Ooh, careful on that. Almost walked into taking Blood Oath. That would have not been a happy time. So really, man, it just comes down to, do we take a Athame or do we take C-section, the new C-section, newly nerfed C-section, however you want to call it. Or we could do something completely different. We could go for an R key. We could go for, try to make some kind of huge epic run here, and get an Omega run. I think for the purposes of the new patch, I want to see the interaction with C-section and Athame. C-section is going to be much, much harder. We could also go for Sacred Orb, but we just had a Sacred Orb on, Saturday. Let's take C-section here. I want to see how the damage coefficient works with the newly nerfed C-section. And I'm going to take the Satanic Bible in hopes that we get a better chance of seeing Athame. And we'll do a few victory laps to make this happen. If our run stays this powerful, which, I mean, there's no reason why to think that it's not going to stay this powerful, especially considering that we have Keeper Sack. I mean, look at the damage we've got. We've got so many good things going for us. What a hell of a start to a first run of the week. Man, oh, man. We might even get ourselves even more money here so we can play around with Keeper Sack even more in the next shop or two. Man. What a start. All right. Well, we have a dice room here, and that is an in-the-room D20. We'll take Mom's Pearls. I'm going to take the money here because I don't want to re-roll the possibility of us not getting any more stats from the shop. So, from what I've been hearing, from what people have been telling me, the new C-section appears to still be okay. That's what I have been told anyway. Now, I have not. Again, this is the first time. This is technically the second time that I'm playing on the patch. But this is the first time that I'm recording. Here, we did do a stream the other day, but I've not seen anything firsthand. I've not watched any videos on, you know, on any of the new changes and stuff. I like to experience that stuff as is and as they show up kind of naturally throughout the course of a regular run here. From what I read in the patch notes, it didn't seem to me like that the C-section nerf was that big of a deal. Yes, you do lose 25% across the board, but C-section also ticks two times more than it previously did. And look at that. There's the new Ouija board. We also don't have... Oh, you know what? I forgot to enable the mod. I forgot to enable... I reinstalled External Information Mod, but I forgot to re-enable it. So anyway, Spectral Tears is a tiers up now, which is good. By Spectral Tears, I mean the Ouija board. So we're going to take both of these here. We're not going to keep Guppy's Head, however. I am going to stick with the Satanic Bible. And we'll go and take Ouija board as well, which does give us a Mr. Squeezy-esque type tears up. So that's great. And good God, that face is horrible. Now, again, this is something I don't normally do because I don't like taking the Satanic Bible and using it for HP because it basically usurps our usual boss items that will drop. And boss items tend to be the biggest source of stat ups in the game. So, Hemolacria C-section? I've ever seen that before? They're just bigger babies. Okay. Oh, they explode and deal Hemolacria-esque damage. Okay. Interesting. I don't think we can get anything... Yeah, we get a damage up. Man, our damage is already insane. Our damage is already, like, in-game levels of insane here. 0.96 for a damage up. Just because we have Cricket's Head and Hemolacria and Keeper Sack. Man, oh, man. Ooh, boy. Hold on. This is going to be a crazy run. Now we got Little Dumpy, we got C-section, we got a whole bunch of things that have changed. Obviously, I'm not going to re-roll this. I would like to get the Soul Heart, though, if we could. It's good enough. You can leave everything else behind. I don't want to re-roll this, as that would be a huge, huge whiff. So the C-section babies are basically just going to heat-seek everything and then explode. Deal Hemolacria-esque type little splash damage there. Man, they are dealing lots of damage. So since we are going to be liberally using the Satanic Bible here, and that's a very weird sentence to say, We're going to essentially always make sure that we have a good amount of HP. The trade-off is that, obviously, we're not going to get the boss drops that we want necessarily anyway. That's the reason why I was so eager to take the mark, because, again, it does give us a rare movement speed upgrade. In fact, the only other movement speed upgrade that I can think of out of a devil deal would be Lord of the Pit, which also wouldn't be bad. I wouldn't mind taking Lord of the Pit. That was a huge, huge lob there. But what a weekend, man. What a weekend it's been. Had ourselves a good tainted random run day. You know, got to watch the Astros win the World Series. Yeah, why not? Get 5 more bombs here from a rocket in a jar. Oh my god, and there's Birthright in here too. What is going on? Please, if this is a theme, I'm gonna lose it. Is Monstrance, which I will take. Monstrance is actually going to help us out with in a huge way with the close quarter combat damage that we're probably going to have to deal with for quite a while in this run. Yeah, Astros get the dub, get the World Series win. Super happy about that. Could take Nail, but again, we're holding on to the Satanic Bible for the specific reason to gain more Devil Deal items. For the purpose of finding a Thame. So far, takeaways from this run are that C-section with the proper amount of damage is still okay. I'm going to be completely honest and say that I don't see much of a change at all here. Now, of course, this is a little bit skewed because of our damage being... What the heck? That baby just yeeted itself across the stratosphere. Obviously, it's a little bit skewed here because of the fact that we've got... We've got just insane amounts of damage. But, I mean, I've had insane amounts of damage before with C-section, and, it's not really striking me as anything problematic here. I enjoyed watching the League of Legends Worlds Championship. Watching T1 go down was I don't like seeing people lose. Or, oh my god, yeah, that might get a little bit. Ouroboros Worm may not work here, team. We'll see. But watching T1 lose was it was a good series. You know, I don't really have a dog in the fight. I wasn't really caring either way for who won. It's always great to see the underdog win. I tweeted out on, it was close to this morning, I guess. I don't remember what time I tweeted it out at, but, talking about how, it was a good world, but still not enough to get me to play League again. Yeah, don't miss League of Legends at all. What is going on here? Sackhead, I'd like to get, but we have no way of actually getting that. And there's deeper. Oh man, there's deep pockets here too. Everything. You talk about coming up Millhouse. This is that saying in like the flesh here. This is an empty room. Yumheart ain't gonna cut it. I would love to get the screw if we could. It's gonna require more money. Oh my god. Get Death's Touch, which is just going to be just another huge amount of damage here. I am going to go ahead and use this key so we finish off the Soul Heart. I think Ouroboros Worm is causing more problems than it's solving. This is much more straightforward. Now, obviously, the tears down from Death's Touch does kind of suck. When you see the damage from Monstrance that we have here is just, it's so potent. I mean, there's nothing that's going to be able to get to us. Not even close. We need to be careful of that right there. Thankfully, we have the blanket to stop that from happening. Get Sack Altar. Now, the sack altar, this was something else that was very peculiar, peculiar in the patch notes. I don't know if holding on to it means that we're going to get more devil deals or just taking it. So I'm not going to keep it because I, you know, we've got Satanic Bible plus we need the HP. But whether I've received no clarity about that yet. So we have 18 bombs. We should absolutely find the secret room. Well, we already found the secret. Never mind. Just kidding. What are we dropping there? Oh, that's right. Sackhead. I don't think there's a way that we can get that. Love to get that tears up as well because C-section. Plus Hamilacker destroys our tears rate. And on top of that, we just picked up Death Touch as well, so. Hangman would be awesome. We get a Wheel of Fortune card. And there's an arcade, but unfortunately, we don't have enough HP to really make it worthwhile. There's the Wishbone. Now, what we could do is we could play the... Right now, the priority is Deep Pockets. It is not the Tears Up. Forgotten Lullaby, yeah, we'll take it. So I don't know if we're going to have enough of a tap here. Unless if we get an HP upgrade inside of the boss trap room. I got a nickel there, all right, well. Need 3 cents. 3 cents in the dream, and that's going to do it. Because there's enough red hearts on this level for us to get much more than just deep pockets here. We may even get a chance to take a stab at getting the screw. And grab the wishbone in case if it actually procs. It usually doesn't. Wow, and we get a nickel too. My goodness, man. Sinvictalux taking a day off or something. That new patch luck, I guess. Yeah, we're going to get enough for not only scooping up deep pockets, but also getting at least one tap, if not many more, on the screw here. So I'm definitely going to just try it while we're here. Don't get it. That's all right. I have no doubt that we're going to get it just from the way that things are going in this run, man. All right, so deep pockets is a go. And that's good stuff for us to have with Keeper Sack. Let's go back and... play the slot machine, or not the slot machine, but the Everett's machine. Doing this to get a couple extra more cents here. This tiers upgrade is worth getting. And looks like the game is going to make us wait a little bit more. Thumbs up, man. Thumbs up for this start. This is one heck of a crazy start that we've got. And it's going to take a little bit for us to grab all these hearts and come back and do this whole song and dance over again, but it's going to be worth it. We're going to be happy we did it. I'm also going to take down these fires because, you know, I'm just going to walk into them. Lucky penny there. Wow, 3.90 luck. Granted, some of that is from Keeper Sack, but... might be one of the most horrifying Isaac faces I've ever seen right there. Halloween's over, Isaac. We're in November now. It's Christmas season, of course. Obligatory... All I want for Christmas is you, rant. Something, something, Mariah Carey rules the world, something, something. I don't know. I don't pay attention to memes. If that wasn't already obvious. Only memes I care about are the memes of the day, which you can go be posting on our... Yeah, go be posting. There you go. That's proper grammar. Which you can go post on this Invicta subreddit, /r/Invicta. We've had all kinds of stuff. We've had artwork. We've had AI-generated art. We've got original artwork. I mean, all sorts of stuff. Finally. Oh man! Now then they put consolation prize there. Well, I'm not going to continue this because this is taking way too long. I know that's a horrible excuse, but I'd like to try to make Boss Rush, which we still honestly, like, unironically have a chance to do. And I'll hold on to the child's heart anyway. Curse the Unknown, no big deal to us. We already know how much HP we've got. Now it's time to play catch up here. Wow, that bomb lasted quite a while. All right, so we basically just have to go into the right direction, which is not this direction, of course. Or is it probably this direction? Very happy the needles now can no longer be champions. That helps us greatly, because the worst thing about needles, whatever. Worst thing about needles is when they're a vortex champion, they spawn right underneath you. I'm not really sure what I could do about the spikes with C-section. Bro. Come on now. This is getting to the ridiculous points of damage here. So another part of the new patch was the fact that Tyrone mentioned that there are multiple new room layouts. Like, many, many, many new room layouts. So I'm down for that. As we've seen with Fiend Folio, I mean, anything... The possibilities are endless when it comes to how many generated room layouts you can get in Isaac. And it really does kind of add just to the overall feeling of depth. It doesn't necessarily make the game deep. It just gives you, like, you know, a little bit more variety and makes it seem less samey throughout the course of your run. So it's, you know, I'm all for that. It's really impressive to see what Nicholas has done with, you know, keeping up with updates and, you know, sort of treating it like a live service game. I mean, yeah, we can debate the reason to nerf a single player offline non-competitive game all we want, but, you know, it still makes it feel like the game is alive. You know what I mean? Like, it's not like we're playing a game that's just a dead game and, you know, no one, including the dev team, pays attention to it anymore. Like, that can be a really demoralizing experience. I've played many games like that, where it's just like, you know, you almost feel like there's no purpose of even doing this, because it's like, well, I mean, it's not receiving updates. People aren't really talking about it. So, you know, who really cares about this game anymore? And, you know, whenever we get this sort of thing here with Isaac, it's still apparent that, you know, the game is still going strong. And, you know, good or bad, depending on how you look at it, it's still nice that the game is receiving updates. You know, and if you don't like it, then you can just simply unmod the anti-nerfs, anti-repentance patch or something like that. You know, the one that undoes all the changes. I mean, hey, I've always said, play the game how you want. It is your game to play however you see fit. And no one can really try to tell you otherwise. If they do, they're a jerk. We don't care about jerks. Mr. Manuel is not going to do it. We get the pact and D-Bizzle. So we are not going to make Boss Rush, unfortunately, but that is okay. We're still going strong with Satanic Bible here. D-Bizzle is going to help us out. We do get the world card. It's really a shame, too, that we missed Boss Rush, because if we didn't take so long on that last floor there, we had a solid chance, especially with this world card, to have made Boss Rush. It would have been close. But the time that we spent, I was kind of hoping for Bob's Rotten Head there. I wanted to hear the new sound effect. The time that we spent on getting money so we could actually afford not only the tiers up but also deep pockets was absolutely worth it. That's going to pay out in dividends as this run keeps continuing to progress and stuff. just help out C-section a little bit. The luck on the soul hearts from fire so far, anyway. I was very happy to have the Astros win. Mama Victa, she's a huge Astros fan, and you know, she gets so invested in anything Astros and Texans, and I get very happy when they win. You know, I'm an Astros fan for sure, but I wouldn't necessarily call myself a Texans fan. I root for them just because I want them to win for Mama Victa. Maybe we can play the reroll machine. Let's wait on that. Boing. This is not Sizzy. This is Keeper's Kin. E-Bizzle. That's two now, and that one actually hit us, you jerk. I better not see that again, son. We have to take jumper cables here. Gives a nice movement speed upgrade, but also another almost 1.5 damage upgrade. Just from simply us buying something in the store. A new sprite. There are a couple of extra sprites and champion sprites and stuff that have been updated. Don't forget, we're still one guppy. We have one guppy item in the bank so far, anyway. Use the 7 cents to reroll here. Not that Nodleaf isn't great, of course. I mean, Nodleaf. Oh my god, Nodleaf plus Monstrance is great, but adding 27.09 damage is even better, I would say. That is some ridiculous damage. Yeah. First of lost. I don't think it's going to matter because everything and anything that we even get near is going to get melted by either way by C-section. That was a great dodge, by the way. Thank you. Either by way of C-section or by way of Monstrance. Hey, we're looking at some major league damage here. Obviously, that completely nuked our tiers rate even more, but there comes a certain point where you don't need to shoot out a whole lot of tiers to make a huge impact on a run. And once your damage is at a certain point, that's a better way to phrase this, it doesn't matter how slow you're firing. As long as you're dealing like some kind of like spectral piercing damage or like, you know, secondary damage that's based off of your base damage, it doesn't matter. C-section will deal persistent damage. If we get in trouble, we just move around. I'm actually surprised that laser hit us. Ran out of real estate up at the top of the room there. Where to God, D-Bizzle. Get on my last nerve, son. You're only here as a courtesy to the people, all right? We already have an HP upgrade. We already have an HP generator here, all right? I didn't even want to re-sign you today. Don't you ever forget that, son. You are absolutely expendable. Definitely want to see what these tarot cards are. Moon card, Temperance Machine. I'm going to hold on to the moon card because that might be a little bit more useful. Go towards the dark room here. I really, really want to see a Thame with this combo. Now that we've taken C-section and have this ridiculous damage, and also, like, don't forget that the Athame effect is now based off of luck. And if, by the way, if you don't know what the Athame changes are, it's something I probably should have let off with. If you don't know what the Athame changes were, Athame, or whatever you want to, however you want to pronounce it, essentially now, instead of it being a black ring around Isaac whenever he takes damage, it's now a tier effect and has a chance to proc after either hitting an enemy or killing an enemy. I think it's killing an enemy. And it's luck-based, so yeah. Another succubus there. We're going to hold off on succubus for a second. And get our obligatory Krampus fight. Wow. Lump of coal as well. Man, oh man. This is astronomical damage we're facing right here. 85 damage. Oh man. This is a room. Whoa there! Hey, C-section. Hey, you want to not do that? I mean, technically it was Hamilacria's fault, but what the heck? I wasn't expecting it to hit a bomb. Yeah, so if you don't know what just happened right there, the Hamilacria effect after C-section disappeared moved my bomb, and I was ill-prepared for that. And just one baby. Like, if we stay in the succubus aura, it's just one baby just kills everything. We get sausage as well. All stats up. Now, we are tier capped, obviously, because we've got Ease Mascara and Hamilacria. Hamilacria is the big limiting factor in that. I would not mind getting Libra. Libra would be pretty insane. At least Isaac has a goofy face now, so that horrific Ouija board Death Touch Hamilacria face. I mean, trust me, Isaac, as a fellow owner of a horrific face, I can tell you something. It ain't pretty all the time, but there are certain limits. Sometimes it's only a face a mother can love. That's just a push. And you bet we're going to be going straight towards Hush, because Hush, it doesn't matter how much boss armor Hush has, he is not going to be able to deal with this. And that also gives us more opportunity to get even more items, and on top of that, we also get a chance to use the shop for more Keeper Sack upgrades. You get another devil deal here, and none of these are a Athame. But I will take contract from below, as that is a huge help to us for not only consumables, but also for coins and that sort of stuff, which leads to more damage and more stat upgrades from Keeper Sack, etc., etc. Another question I've been fielding is, do I know whether or not the G Fuel item is an actual item in the game or not? I don't know. I would assume not. I assume it's only made for the Easter egg seed, which you can replay, by the way. I'll take Tooth and Nail here. Yeah. A little bit of a disappointing shop here, but we're still going to be able to make pretty good bank. Oh. Okay. So we get a reroll machine in the form of the reverse judgment card. We maxed out our usage of the shop there. Ooh, man. Pyromaniac or lead pencil? We gotta go lead pencil, right? Surely. Lead pencil gonna give us the monstrous lung effect. Man, oh man, we're just. This is like an all-star run, man. One thing we need is Sissy. And a Athame. We need to be sticking with Succubus here as long as possible. In fact, it might be in our best interest just to follow her. Saw the C-section, or the lead pencil tears there, and yeah, Hush is just getting chomped to pieces. Especially with the way that the damage coefficient works with a lump of coal and C-section, is just going to be doing buku of damage. At 95.76 damage in the Succubus aura. If you're wondering how we're getting charges back on the Satanic Bible despite us still being in the same room, it's because we have the jumper cables. Every 15 enemies that we kill, we gain one charge, and if you kill enough enemies fast enough, you can give yourself quite the amount of charges. And yeah, Hush, old Hush, he goes down like a sack of potatoes, and surprising absolutely nobody there. And we are still cruising along. More money just equals more firepower for us to get with the shop. Also, apparently we have zero range right now. It's really our shot speed that's kind of hurting our lead pencil procs, but what can you do? Tendon rock in here, which we probably won't have any use for. Oh my gosh. Did you see the health bar of greed just implode from the spiders? Shout out to the blue map helping us out. Point us in the right direction. And this is not even going to be this is not even going to be close. Yeah. He was actually one shot. Oh, Stanley, you big dummy, stomping right down on all those spiders. It's Dark Prince's crown, Guppy's hairball, Guppy's eyes. There's Guppy for us. And unfortunately, the secret room is not going to produce us much of a teleport towards Lamb, but hey, there's Kane's other... No, that's glaucoma. It's not Kane's other eye. Kane's other eye, another change in the newest patch. Same thing goes for Blastocyst, who received a almost 100% HP increase in his first form. Not that it mattered here, of course. And with Guppy now, that's just going to be even more just disgusting damage. These flies are going to be dealing just ungodly amounts of damage to anything that they touch. It doesn't matter if they get destroyed by Mask of Infamy. We'll get plenty more. The instant activation and the constant uptime on the targets from C-section is going to make sure of that. Certainly one of the most powerful runs that we've seen in quite a while. A minor inconvenience running through two champion ragmen. It takes D-Bizzle longer to walk to the, or float to the red hearts than it does for us to actually clear the room. That's when you know you've got a good run. Got a multi-dimensional baby and mom's razor blade. So, conjoined is certainly a transformation that we definitely want here. But don't blink, because Lamb's going to go down real quick. Yeah. Absolutely. Let's do it, Mosh Pit. Second C, Delta 8 Bravo Whiskey, Bravo 8 Echo 2. All right, so we're still on the lookout for... Sure, why not, Blood Puppy? We're still on the lookout for a Tham. I'm going to back out and go back in because they still didn't fix that visual glitch. If you go on a victory lap and stuff like Shade or Multi-Dimensional Baby is in your run, they just start glitching out and basically look very seizure-y. Yeah, man, we are primed for a Tham as well with this luck rating. Oh my gosh. Contract from below is just... Everything is just on this run is just ridiculous. Play the seed. Play both of these seeds. If you want to start out, it's an excellent way to do so if you want to try the new Athame anyway. You start out with freaking Death Certificate. What more could you want? Grab these here real quick. I don't really care about using keys instead of bombs, even though we have more bombs. Dunce Habit, eh. We'll take it just to take it. Two of Spades doubles our keys. Teen Scent or Member Access. Okay. There's the new Glowing Hourglass, which we're not going to use. Hey, we can use it if you want to see it, but Pandora's Box gives us 2 Soul Hearts. Buying it essentially just to get the stats from it, but we're still not gonna stick with it though. We've got more than enough firepower to overcome the loss of life, loss of HP, I should say, from taking the Devil Deals here. We get Pogatory. We get to see the new Pogatory as well. Although Purgatory didn't change really hardly at all. They just made it more visually obvious where Purgatory is on the screen over water and cracks, and or not cracks, but holes and stuff. We get a Stars card. Now, I don't know which one of these... I don't know if we use the Stars card, I don't know which item it's going to get rid of. I don't want it to get rid of C-section. There's a... no, that's not Abyss. That's Echo Chamber. Oh, my God. Oh, we got rid of Blood Puppy. That's fine. A Cracked Orb and Isaac's Tomb. So there's the crack from Pogatory. Wow. The explosion, just the ring of damage. Ring of death from a lead pencil. It's Squeezy, which gives us no tiers upgrade. As neither a Thame nor other. Apparently I also didn't use the Satanic Bible on this floor. I thought I did. Okay. Us getting hit there opened up a crawl space. Linger Bean, which we don't want. Or do we want Boom? Yeah, Dead Bird, come on. Come on with it. Get a Judgment here. Not interested in playing it. Just want to try to get a little bit of extra sense, but we accidentally tapped it. And we actually can go into our boss trap room here. By way of the secret room. Marble, sure. I would want to swallow either... I mean, Fishtail is great with Guppy. So we definitely could try to purposely take damage here. There we go. All right, so we swallowed Fishtail. Go back, and we can swallow Pay to Win as well, and then maybe get Dim Bulb. There we go. Obviously, we don't care about the loss of HP. Stapler's just going to be even more ridiculous damage on top of the bonus that we get from Keeper Sack. My goodness. Absolutely, positively insane amounts of damage on this run, and I'm loving it. Yeah. Oh, we had Isaac's Tomb. It's like I always forget about school bag. We don't care about those trinkets. Lost soul, buddy. Alright. We do have BFF, so Lost Soul Buddy will get Holy Mantle. So there's a chance that he might live. Check him out now. Lost Soul Buddy right about now. It's Paul, we don't really care about. Already got the Gupster. The Fly Trinket, by the way, the Fishtail that we swallowed, that will make us produce double the amount of flies that we create whenever we create a fly. So essentially every time that our tier hits an enemy, we will spawn more flies than just one. So it's basically just a huge DPS boost. Of course, we also swallowed the Pay to Win, which is going to guarantee us the reroll pedestal that you've been seeing in the item rooms. Okay. We get death lists. Sure. Saved you, Lost Soul Buddy. We got 27 bombs. We should try to turn these bombs into some money here. Apparently got plenty of them. A Bum Friend was another change that I've not seen yet. The Bum Friend... Now, in the patch notes, Tyrone said that Bum Friend has a chance to pay out with items. I don't know if that meant, like, items as in, like, passive items. Or if he meant items as in consumables. He wasn't very clear on that, so... Again, that's going to be one of those things that the Mosh Pit can clarify down below. Yeah, we get a 4.5 damage up from Death's List. Lucky Toe. The 1-2-3 combo there from C-Section. And we're still just looking for the shop. That's all I really care about. I don't understand what is hitting Lost Soul Buddy. The relic for 45 cents. Yeah. I mean, if we could afford it, like, I definitely would, but... Now, they get Isaac's tier or tier detonator as well. Yeah. Now, that just happened to trigger right as Lead Pencil Procced. So it's not always going to look like that. Isaac's tears did get changed for the better. Even though, again, I haven't seen it yet. It does a it does have a damage boost much like Tammy's head does. Whenever you use that. My soul buddy paying out with some goodies. Along with us getting some more help from Isaac's tomb. A steam sale. We were bamboozled. You get a shot speed upgrade. I don't know if this is conjoined or not. I think Lil Steven is conjoined. No, it was 2 or 3. Okay. Normally, I would have held on to... Held on to Isaac's tears, but given the fact that we're trying to force a Thane to come out, that's the main reason why I'm sticking with the Satanic Bible, even though we don't really... We haven't needed the Satanic Bible in a while. But if we get a Thane, then that's the icing on the cake of this incredible run. Remote detonator. This is going to give us a luck and range upgrade from Dad's Lost Coin. A black candle, which I do want, just to prevent us from getting getting curses. So in case we do find a Thame, it won't be via Curse of the Blind. Our unbuffed damage is now 86. Oh my god. Well, we definitely don't want a second D-Bizzle. One's bad enough. One of you lot's bad enough here. Does this baby give conjoined? It does. There you go. Conjoined fans rejoice. He finally took it. One of the few cases I don't mind taking conjoined here. It just allows for more shots to go across the map. Mom's bracelet here, which we don't care about. I think I saw that our buff damage is 128. Yeah, 128 damage in the succubus aura. We're going to keep going until hopefully we find a Thame. I mean, we'll see a Thame eventually. If not on this run, then eventually. You know, I had a chance to pick it up from death certificate. I still would take C-section because I wanted to see exactly what the... No pun intended there. I wanted to see exactly what the change looked like. And I think that even without our massive amount of damage that we've got on this run, I think C-section is still going to be just fine. It still pierces. It still does the constant damage. You know, it still is heat-seeking and stuff. So I'm not overly concerned with the C-section change at all. I think that it is a... You know, it's whatever. Take the chaos card for old Hushy so we can go and get some more items. Oh my god. Oh, Chubb, what do we do to you? Yeah, I got lost in one of the C-section babies there. Jar of lemonade, we don't care about. Friend finder is great, but not what we're looking for. Little Brimmy. Little Brimmy did get a slight buff. Okay. Wow, unbelievably, we're still making all these deaths list procs happen. We get PH Dizzle along with Birthright. Makes you small. Oh, God. I forgot about Echo Chamber. I think we just gave up C-section. Did we? No. That's from Multidimensional, maybe. And I guess we'll try out the new Voodoo Ed. Yeah, I totally forgot about Echo Chamber. I don't know what we gave up there. We still have Hamilacria, from what I can tell. Let's see what else we give up here. What I should be doing is I should be using these inside of the secret room. Any card that we get while we still have the reverse stars card active, we should be using this inside of the secret room for the chance to get an R key or another death certificate. So that is Vanishing Twin. Still don't know what we gave up there. It's not showing us anything. Unless Echo Chamber isn't... Unless it's not using the Stars card, like, are we giving up items? Normally, if you use a reverse Stars card, Isaac will hold something up above his head, and that something would be what you're giving up. But I didn't notice him do that the last two times there. I definitely didn't notice him do it there. It means if we use a Chaos card, it's going to, again, give us a... we can use these... I mean, all these pills. Echo Chamber is going to basically duplicate the last three or last four items that we've used. So I think that we've got one more use out of the Reverse Stars card. Tears up. And it's Astral Plane, Astral Projection, I should say. And the other one wasn't important enough for me to remember. So we can get another tiers up. Not that it matters because we're tiers capped here. The whole purpose of this is just to simply try to get an R key or a death certificate. We're still going to be taking the one that makes you small. Okay, yeah, we're out. Okay. And we did lose Hamilacria. You can tell because our damage went down a whole lot. Did we lose Hamilacra or did we lose Cricket's Head? I think we lost Cricket's Head. I'm trying to see what the babies are doing. Unfortunately, our range is too high, so I can't really observe. Okay, yeah, we lost Cricket's Head. Up, speed up, speed up, health up, health. Yeah, so you see us gaining HP there. And 9 lives and Guppy's Head again. Gotta be running out of Devil Dew items soon. Bloody Gust and 7 seals. I mean, we might as well take them at this point. We're taking everything else. We're gonna be really small on the screen though, because obviously we took all those one that makes you smaller pills. A soul buddy helping us out. We get mom's ring and give us a damage up. But thankfully, we didn't get rid of our C-section. We did get rid of, I think we got rid of Guppy's eye. But we're still Guppy no matter what. No, we still have Guppy's eye. Okay. It's just weird that we weren't able to see what exactly, what items we were giving away there. Clear rune, we don't really care about clear rune. Fortunately, we did lose the chaos card, but I don't think it's that huge of a deal. All things considered, even though we did lose a majority of our damage because we got rid of Cricket's head, it was a risk we were willing to take. I can't. All I see is Lost Soul Buddy. There's Isaac. Just look for Mom's razor. That's where Isaac is. Or better yet, look for Mom's knife. So hard here. I think that we were even smaller at this point. At this point, don't even try to find Isaac. It's not worth it. Funny here. It is very difficult to pick things up off the ground when you're this small. Saw that spider debizzle. I think I didn't. But yeah, we're full HP. Little squeak out of Isaac there. Okay, stuff's sticky sack. Sticky bombs are the ones that got changed. There's Dad's key. We could go fight Megastan, but still want to hold on to Satanic Bible just because we want to force the Devil Deal item. Fortunately, the shop is the only thing that we haven't seen. That's the only thing that we wanted to see because obviously with the membership card has a chance to spawn a Thame in there. I think. Got the quarter. Oh, no, we gave up the membership card. Never mind. Okay, so that was another one of the items that we yeeted into the nether. Jesus juice, gonna give us some more damage back. I mean, our damage is still real good. It's almost 60, so gotta get a move on here. We don't want to miss boss rush second time. No excuses on this one. A little bit of a longer run. Granted, we're doing some targeted item finding, so we're taking a little bit longer than we normally would on such an overpowered run. Trying to be thorough, trying to see the new items, which we can. So Devil Deal, and that is not Echo Chamber, that is Abyss. Yeah, those aren't really worth doing. What a crazy, crazy start to the week here on a Monday. See more and more trinkets just showing up left and right. And I'm gonna go ahead and throw the... I'll take Left Hand. Left Hand has a chance to give us teleport to the Devil Deal, so I might as well do that. Get a Tears up there. Pretty big one at that, thanks to Death's List. Thankfully. Definitely use it. Now, of course, Voodoo Head was also changed in the patch, which is a guarantee that you get a coin inside of the curse rooms if you have Voodoo Head. Now, that change was not something that I was really kind of keen on. I was like, eh, whatever, that sounds like a pretty needless change. But a very astute member of the Mosh Pit pointed out that the fact that there's coins inside of this inside of the first rooms now means that the keeper can get into them now without risking, like, you know, just death. And I thought that was a great point to bring up, which is certainly something that was obtuse enough to where I wouldn't have thought about that. But that is true. If there's if we get coins now guaranteed inside of the curse rooms, that means that the keeper and tainted keeper alike are both going to have reason to go into them, into the curse rooms now. So, you know, I really like that, sort of like that change. This is the last time we'll have to use the Satanic Bible here. There's a sacrifice room. The reason why I say it's the last time is because essentially, come on, guys. This is the last time we're going to be seeing any item rooms. Teleport to the Devil Deal, and it's money equals power. This is going to be a significant damage upgrade. Still no Athame, though. They can't even... I mean, nothing can get... can get close to us. There they go. So no Athame, unfortunately. That is, I think that is the Athame dream dead, unless it somehow miraculously shows up in the chest. And yeah, we can take the red key. We got the cracked, we have the cracked orb, so might be able to suss out where the Ultra Seek room is. See, I do a little bit of hunting here. Looks to the right of here is what I would say. I'd be correct. Can be conception. I mean, it's another Devil Deal item out the door, I suppose. All right, Isaac, you'll be all right. Rub some dirt in it, you'll be all right. That all the HP. I will go check to see what's in this secret room here, just in case there's an R key or death certificate. I wouldn't mind death certificate again. I mean, that would at least give us guarantee the Athame chance. Or not, that's fine too. There's a teleport to the Devil Deal here. I know it's a teleport because essentially, if the chests are empty, then that indicates that they are a Devil Deal. By empty, I mean we can see when there's nothing in the chests by way of Guppy's eye. So it makes a dead giveaway. Get magic skin. Now magic skin can also produce us some secret rooms, secret room items here. So. It ain't over yet. Weird shackles. Normally I wouldn't be taking, I wouldn't be caught dead with magic skin, but one time where, you know, we're trying to make it happen. We're fine. I'm willing to let it ride here. We already know that we got everything. We got the run in the bag. At this point, we're going through the motion. All that HP there. Looking nice and pretty. We get ourselves fast bombs, which has a very neat interaction with a rocket in a jar. Still have it. A horse pill. That's a huge tears up. All I'm trying to do is pick this up, thank you. Book of Belial here. Oh my god, look at the damage from the flies. Yeah, old Hushy didn't have, he had no prayer there. And neither will the rest of the game, so if we don't get a Thame, you know, we tried for it, for sure. Oh, thank you. I'm not going to be heartbroken if we end up not getting it. It'd be cool to see, but I mean, it's a permanent change to a Thame, so like it's not like we're never ever going to see a Thame again. We got to see C-section though. We got to have one of the craziest starts, if not the best start that I've ever seen in any single Isaac run ever, which I am absolutely down for. Excuse me. Get Omega, which by Omega I mean flip. Might as well be Omega, though. Get a few extra charges here if we run into things with Nun's Habit. It's not the best use of HP, but allows us to take a few more cracks at the secret room. Chaos is not what we're looking for. So you see the coins in there. Go get another charge on magic skin. Some of this money here. I'm not gonna obsess over picking up every little penny anymore. We've got enough damage. I mean, you know, all we're doing now is just fulfilling the meme and doing full clears. We're an hour and almost 13 minutes in this video, and we still have not gotten what we're looking for. Wanted to go one more tap on magic skin here. There goes Isaac. Save your life, lost soul, buddy. Now remember, we've got Nun's Habit, so if we really wanted to push it, I mean, we could try to get more out of magic skin with the full charges. I don't think picking up flip would actually matter. Raw liver. Oh. Yeah, we have to be in possession of flip before spawning an item pedestal in order for us to get that, so. Alright, I know we're leaving some soul hearts behind. Not that big of a deal, however. A foregone conclusion here, and I did swallow the left hand, so this is going to give us red hearts when we go to the chest here, which again is not that big of a deal. In fact, that helps us out if we're going to try to get a Thame, and we get Brimstone, Maw of the Void, not the right one, Stigmata as well. By that I mean Blood of the Martyr. Get Leviathan. Yeah, what is our cooldown of Brimstone going to be? A tears rate with Brimstone is ridiculous. It's 0.19 tears. Yikes. Our tears do more damage than we do. It's looking like the C-section Brimstone synergy no longer exists. Unless it's just because our tears rate is so bad. Because of Ease Mascara. Oh, Whoa there, buddy. Oh yeah, I was gonna show what the, if you've never seen the fast bombs and rocket in a jar synergy. I'll show it to you against Blue Baby. It's pretty epic. Apparently we were full on hearts. I'm just trying to get out the door at this point. Go to tears. So thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed it. If you did, make sure you click that like button. Man, one heck of a run, I'll tell you what. But an hour and 16 minutes is about where I got to call it. So, man, play that first seed for yourself. Let me know in the comments down below if you're on PC, if you're enjoying the patch, if you're not enjoying the patch, what are you enjoying or not enjoying about it? Again, post all those stuff in the comments down below. We love to see the discussion in the mosh pit. And have a great start to your week, everyone. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Paul, Anthony Agresta, Kaizo Blades, Bataloid, Melamantito, and Tony Baloney. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, then check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find at patreon.com/Sinvicta.